In today's session, we are going to see applications of Astable mode of IC555 timer. At the end of today's session, students will be able to explain some of the application circuits of IC555 timer in Astable mode. These are the contents of my today's presentation. The students should pause video here and think over this question and then continue. How to obtain 50% duty cycle for Astable multivibrator output signal? Now, for normal Astable multivibrator using IC555, the output signal is a rectangular wave signal. The duty cycle is a ratio of the time duration for which output signal remains high to total time period of the output signal. For normal output of Astable multivibrator using 555, the duty cycle is more than 50%. The time duration for which output remains high is more than the time duration for which output remains low. When external capacitor, the time duration in which the external capacitor charges from 1/3 VCC to 2/3 VCC, the output signal of Astable multivibrator remains high, and the time duration for which the external capacitor discharges from 2/3 VCC to 1/3 VCC, the output signal of Astable multivibrator remains low. So, capacitor charging time is more than the capacitor discharging time. That's why the output signal of Astable multivibrator is high for more time and low for less time. That's why duty cycle is more than 50%. So, how to get a 50% duty cycle for output signal of Astable multivibrator? If we make capacitor charging time is equal to capacitor discharging time, so the time duration for which output remains high and will become equal to the output remains low. So in this way, we'll get a 50% duty cycle for output signal of Astable multivibrator. So output of Astable multivibrator, now it is converted from rectangular wave signal to a square wave signal with 50% duty cycle. Now let us see square wave oscillator. Now this is a circuit diagram for a square wave oscillator circuit or square wave generator using IC555 working in Astable mode. In this circuit diagram, the output is taken from pin number 3. Pin number 8 is connected to VCC. Pin number 4 is also joined to VCC. The two resistors RA and RB are connected to pin number 7 and pin number 2 and 6. Capacitor C is connected between pin number 6 and ground. In addition to this, the additional diode is connected parallel to resistor RB across RB. Pin number 1 is connected to ground, and capacitor C1 is connected between pin number 5 and ground, that is the control input, to avoid any noise problem at the control input of IC555. Astable multivibrator can be implemented and configured using IC555 to generate symmetrical square wave signal of a required frequency and with 50% duty cycle. For this, a diode D is connected across resistor RB as shown in figure 1. The capacitor C charges through resistor RA and diode D to approximately a 2/3 of a VCC. The charging time constant is RA into C. So the resistor RB is completely bypassed due to diode D. When capacitor charges, diode conducts and resistor RB is bypassed. The time for which the output equals a high voltage level is given by the TC is equal to 0.693 RA into C seconds. TC stands for capacitor charging time. The capacitor charges from 1/3 VCC to 2/3 VCC, for which the output signal of IC555 remains high. And capacitor C discharges through resistor RB and pin 7, that is internal discharge transistor. The discharging time constant is RB into C, the time for which the output equals low voltage level is given by TD is equal to 0.693 RB into C. So the time duration for which the external capacitor discharges from 2/3 VCC to 1/3 VCC, the discharging time constant RB into C. So time is given by 0.693 RB into C, for which the output remains low. When voltage across capacitor falls to 1/3 VCC, again C charges, again external capacitor charges to 2/3 VCC through resistor RA and diode D. The timer output again becomes high. If the two external resistors RA and RB are selected such that RA equal to RB, then capacitor charging time TC is equal to capacitor discharging time TD. So charging time equal to discharging time. So the time duration for which output remains high is equal to the output remains low. Thus the duty cycle is 50%. That is percentage D is equal to 50%. This cycle is repeated and we are getting a continuous square wave signal at the timer output with 50% duty cycle. For resistor RA equal to RB, resistor RA must be combination of fixed resistor R and potentiometer, so that a potentiometer can be adjusted to get exact square wave signal at the output of square wave oscillator circuit. Now let us go for the second applications of Astable mode of IC555, that is a pre-running ramp generator. It generates a continuous ramp signal. This is figure number 2. This is circuit diagram for a ramp signal generator using IC555. In addition to external capacitor connected between pin number 6 and ground, the in place of resistor RA and RB, two additional components, diode D and transistor Q, are connected, and base of transistor is connected to ground. Pin number 7, 2 and 6 are joined together and connected to the common point of transistor collector and capacitor. Pin number 4 and 8 are connected to plus VCC, and output is taken from pin number 3. IC555 is working in a stable mode. That is, no any state of output is stable, both the states are unstable. To avoid any noise problem, the additional capacitor C1 of 0.01 microfarad is connected between pin number 5 and ground. Pre-running ramp generator can be implemented and configured by replacing the resistor RA and RB with current mirror circuit using transistor and diode. This current mirror circuit causes charging and discharging of external capacitor C at constant rate. An unstable multi-operator is configured to act as a free-running ramp signal generator, is shown in figure number 2. While charging of capacitor C, when the voltage across capacitor C goes on increasing and equals 2/3 VCC, the internal comparator 1 sets off the internal flip-flop that turns on a discharge transistor, and capacitor C discharges very rapidly through discharge transistor. So voltage across capacitor goes on decreasing. When voltage across capacitor C becomes approximately equal to 1/3 VCC, again the lower comparator, that is comparator 2, turns off internal discharge transistor. So capacitor C again begins charging up, thus capacitor charging and discharging cycles are continuously repeated as shown in figure number 3. So charging time is equal to 0.693 into, for all practical purposes, the time period of output ramp signal waveform is equal to the charging time TC. The discharging time of capacitor TD is relatively negligible in comparison to its charging time TC. The time period is given by T is equal to VCC into C divided by 3 into IC, where IC is equal to VCC minus VB upon R. The free running frequency of ramp generator is given by FO equal to, that is reciprocal of time period, 1 upon T, so that is equal to 3 into IC upon VCC into C, and frequency is measured in hertz. So output waveform is shown in figure number 3. So this figure number 3 shows output voltage waveform of ramp generator signal. The output voltage switches between two voltage levels, plus VCC and 0 volt. The time duration TC in which the capacitor charges from 1/3 VCC to 2/3 VCC, the output remains high. And the time duration in which capacitor discharges from 2/3 VCC to 1/3 VCC, the output remains low. The time TC is much greater than the time TD. The discharging time is negligibly small, so the output, at the output we are getting continuous a ramp signal. This is a reference. Thank you.